Well, it's Wednesday. In Denver, Colorado. Wednesday's weekly traumatic displacement of our unhoused neighbors. I'm on 21st and what am I? Welton, 21st and Welton. This morning. Let's see what's going on over here today. Denver. Oh, hi. You're watching me. Denver. See the big crane down there? Look at this. It's huge. Tall. Apartment building. People don't get out of the way. Get out of the way, people. It's freaking ambulance going. keep driving. See, when was the last time we were here?
No. All the days blend
parked all these other. I have more food. I have more food, guys. Oh, it's just everything. Okay, small enough.
Oh. Thank you, Kara.
Yeah, it's bread pudding. It's got lots of eggs. Oh, good. We have some food. Looks like people are eating.
Hey there.
You having cereal?
Yeah, we had cereal. We had oatmeal pastries, but they're
gone.
One of it is gone. Yeah.
Well, they. When did they start here?
I got here around 6.
You know what? I got syrup on the car. That'd be good on top of it. It's bread, but look at it. Let's see what it looks like. I just like threw it in the oven.
Ooh, peaches.
Yeah, and apricots. Whoa. Peaches, grapes, and apricots. Like, it's bread pudding. There's lots of eggs in there. So. Do you want some pudding? Do you want some bread pudding, Penny? It looks really good. I parked all the way around the corner. I parked over here. Huh?
I parked down there.
You parked down there?
I'm kind of peeking out, so.
I know, it makes you feel weird. Which one is it? Black? The black one?
Yeah.
The one that's peeking out?
There was a coffee park right next to me.
Yeah, I was blocking Evan Dryer the other day.
That's amazing.
Yeah. And I said, do you need me to back out? And no, instead he had the cop car move in front of him. So I said, I guess he was leaving for the day. They're not gonna go anywhere. I guess they're gonna stay right there. Morning. Morning. Oh, crunch, crunch, crunch. Yes. Stop, ask, exempt. If they let you know, let them go. What the law says, it says there are two ways in which a person is to be exempted from paraphernalia laws. You should know both. The syringe exchange participants, people who are enrolled in a syringe exchange program are exempted from paraphernalia charges. The law exempts participants from drug paraphernalia laws. Needle stick prevention law. This law exempts people from arrest, ticketing, or charge when they disclose the possession of a syringe prior to a pat-down or vehicle search. The law encourages individuals who have syringes on their person to disclose them prior to being searched. What the data says, nationally, about 1 in 3 officers have been struck by a syringe during their career. Here in Denver, that rate is a little better, about 1 in 5. Most officers who report being stuck by needles were injured during a search subject to an arrest. Why it matters. These exemptions have been codified into law to promote officer safety. The use of sterile syringes prevents the spread of HIV and viral hepatitis. A person's disclosure of a syringe prior to being searched helps reduce the likelihood of an officer being struck by a syringe. Please note, the laws cover both sterile and used syringes. Residual drugs left in a used syringe are to be exempted the same as sterile syringes. Thank you, Ray.
Thanks.
Morning, John.
How many unhoused neighbors were here today?
About 30.
Wow. 35. Wow.
Yeah, I mean, this morning, I think by the time we got here, some folks...
But they were here. That's where they were. This is where they were residing.
I remember being here. And, you know, all the days and weeks flow into one another. It's like, I just remember being here just the other day.
It used to be this, and now it's all plastic and rocks.
Oh, and I remember this building over here. This building is the building that the federal
National Security Agents use it.
Yes. National Security Agents use this building to park in. So. Anything happened today?
No, I mean, these campers are super resilient. They're really autonomous. They know how to do this really well.
Well, yeah, they have to do it over and over and over again.
Yeah, I mean, this is some of the most experienced
movers.
Yeah. So.
Moving alongers.
Everyone's doing okay.
Okay, good.
No major losses of items yet.
Good. That's the hardest thing. The sickest thing.
A couple empty tents that we didn't know were abandoned or not, but you know, nobody's come back.
Claimed them. Thanks. I brought bread for the day with food in it. It's got eggs and milk and fruit and bread. I don't know. No, with lots of sugar, though.
Lots of
sugar. No. Morning. Oh, you work over there. This is nice and convenient for you. Yep, I'm sure you can get in there. They'll just ask you what you're doing there. Nicholas Dahl, hi. Right here, honey. Fuck you, man. look at somebody else. Somebody else trying to get through? I know. No, they expect you to go around. They expect you to go around, hun. There's the gate. I guess they loved her. Oh, there's a good guy over here. Gotta move those rocks. So they're going to let you in on that side, I guess.
I reckon.
It's ridiculous. Isn't it ridiculous? Is it like this fencing? Box off the... And the sweep?
Making
and
people
move?
Leave. Yeah.
Every... This is where they get their services. That's why they're living.
Yes.
Yes.
People
so
get services
I'm on Facebook Live. So are you from out of town, you said?
Yeah, I'm from Alabama.
You're from Alabama? Did you just get here?
I got here in February, but I got... Came homeless in July. Yeah,
uh-huh.
July.
Uh-huh. And when you so how your experience in Denver?
has been since July has been years.
I hate it.
Yeah.
I want to get the fuck out of here.
Uh-huh. So you're over here at Peak?
Yeah, I'm trying to get over to Urban Peak.
Uh-huh.
One, to where I can eat.
Yes.
Two, where I can...
So you know what? I brought some bread pudding with fruit in it over there.
Oh my God.
It's right over there on the table, honey. And then we got coffee too and water. So go get some. You're welcome.
Bread pudding in a long time.
You're welcome, honey.
Thank you, honey.
You're welcome. That's so sad. So that's why this community is here, because they get, this is where their services are. So, you know, just think. Maybe put some bathrooms, public restrooms, pick up some trash around here. Do some trash pickup, that would be good. Did you get something to eat or some coffee over here?
No, not yet.
Not yet. Well, we got some little bit of food over here.
Yeah.
Morning. It's another day. It's another traumatic displacement day in Denver, Colorado. A weekly occurrence, three times a week. All around Denver. So this is John. Is this Anna? This is suite number 83? Something like suite number 83 for the year. Last year, Denver conducted a total of 34 suites for the total of the year, right? 34?
34. And I think the year before that, it was 17.
People that are like in the tent, do they just pick up all their stuff and throw it away? Or?
Sometimes that happens.
Sometimes it gets thrown away by the city. Sometimes it gets destroyed in the process of being moved, especially when it's really cold. Sometimes the bottom will be frozen to the ground, and when they try to pick it up, they'll rip it, and then they don't have it.
A lot of times they lose half of what they own every time they have to
lose everything.
Some people lose everything.
IDs,
medication,
prosthetic devices, medications,
wheelchairs,
family heirlooms, pictures.
Everything that
anything you can think of.
Yeah.
Anything you might hang on to.
And every couple of weeks they have to keep doing the same thing over and over.
This happens three times a week.
Yes, but I mean people get moved from place to place. Well, they don't even get moved. They are told to move along with no solutions. Very often with no solutions. Are you a neighbor, a resident? Are you working in the neighborhood?
I work at the airport.
Oh, you work.
In all of them.
Do you have any fires or
something?
No. Here you go. Here's some more information.
Thank you.
You're welcome. And look up Message to the Mayor 2 documentary. Message to the Google Message to the Mayor.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Oh, he's got the message.
Well, there's a documentary that was just...
Yeah, there's a documentary.
Yeah.
He's hearing everything you're saying right now.
I'm sorry, I couldn't...
He hears you right now. He's hearing everything you're saying right now.
I don't know if he's hearing you or not.
Oh, yeah. Trust me.
Well, that wouldn't be good.
No, it wouldn't.
That'd be
rude. That would be terrible for the city.
That would be really bad for the city. We're going to be testing a bunch of... an apartment.
A big number was like 120 for 100,000. Alabama, I saw a number. That's the number. I don't even want to say. It's like thousands. I saw a number that said 16,000. It's just nuts. I'm going back to the house.
Thank you.
going on. $100
That's kind of tempting, huh? No?
but if you have a cigarette, you got to give me $200.
Oh. Well, in that case, I'm definitely not taking that bet.
No, definitely not taking that bet.
I'd be down $100 in 2 hours.
Yeah.
I got you. Oh, yeah, hemp cigarettes. Yeah, those are nice. They just don't give you the same buzz.
No. But they can help.
You want fixation. I think a lot of it is like nervous energy at this point.
Yeah. It's the oral.
Because if I'm like chilled and relaxed, then like, I smoke 75% less.
Yeah.
But like at a sweep, this is like my third cigarette.
I know, me
too.
Usually
never have 3 cigarettes before 10 a.m. Like, that's very unlike me. But at a sweep, I just...
Just smoke like a chimney.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Me too.
Well, I can totally... I can appreciate that. You know, I can.
My grandpa used to smoke 2 packs a day until he was like 65. Took out half his lung.
Kept smoking.
No, he quit for about 20 years, and then when he was 85, he was like, fuck it. And then he just started smoking again. So I figure I got like good genes.
Yeah.
No, 2 packs a day, shit, I've never been that bad. He was doing that since World War II, so like.
Like my buddy Ray's like, smoking, he's like, so I take supplements. I don't know, Ray, I don't think
I just feel like
cuts it, but it doesn't work.
In 10 years, when I'm in the middle of a water war, I'm not going to be worried about lung cancer, you know? Like, I'm going to be worried about fighting off the fiends with, you know, for my water.
Yeah.
Whiskey to drink it and water to fight. We're getting there.
Oil wars are very passe.
That's a passe.
There goes a tent. And focus it. Dang it. Focus. Stupid Vince. I missed it because I got no focus. Perfectly good tent. Look, I have a... Let's see. I have a... Look, it's too close. What is that? What is that? It's a banana. It's a frozen banana.
And so, but we could...
Have you had to do any vehicle support today? Have you had to do any vehicle support today?
Not yet. I don't, haven't seen anyone ask. I think Jeff will be the one taking it. But it has to go far. They can't be in like a, this whole block. So I feel like they would have to go far.
Because they've got fences everywhere, don't they?
Yeah. Some of them.
A little tiny section fence. A little tiny section fence over here. For these, what, was there one tent there?
Yeah, two.
There were two tents there, and they fenced them off over there by themselves, right? And then I was watching Anna's stream earlier, and she was like, there's fences everywhere. So they want,
they let people out on, like, this busy street.
I know. They, this is where they let them out. They don't care. I hate this fence so much. I hate it so much. There we go. He just kicked him out. He was sitting over there in the. He was just sitting over there in the bus stop. Huh? Kicked him out.
Thank you.
Oh good, I finally got something about work here. I can always follow you up on your RAD ID. Okay. Check your email for instructions. I have been. Everybody, thanks for thank you for joining us today on another traumatic displacement Wednesday in Denver, Colorado, or on California. And where are we on? 21st, I'm sorry. 21st of California. Duchess was here a little while ago. Of course. So the reason these people are living here is because they have the services right here that they need.
To me, privileges are responsibilities. So for example, I have an education, which is a privilege, so I use my education to leverage for people who do not have it and don't have that
access. But he's probably worked very, very hard.
Hi, Peppers. Hi, Peppers.
So what's the story? If it does look abandoned, and they just, like, they just...
What, do they have a trash?
They can't fucking salvage things.
Okay.
So...
Because that would be ridiculous to salvage purposely
good
stuff.
So the guy that's at the back of the truck, just... Yeah, so the one with the red grate on the back window?
Yes.
The guy who's at the dump truck right now picked up what looked like quite a nice white road bike.
You can see the wheel popping up.
Yeah,
oh, I see
it. And he
it.
Put it in the truck.
It's just a whole bike. Oh my gosh.
Yeah, I mean, it looked like it was brand new, so it was probably recently stolen.
Well, yeah, but still, it was a bike. Brand
new
bike.
Yeah, but it's not his to take.
No, is it?
Can't salvage shit.
Conover was standing right there.
Court. Right, I know, I don't know. You see a bike that might be an issue, and you just watch it being trash.
I'm so sorry. No, this isn't trash.
Of course, honey. I know you have to go. It's a fence. Don't apologize. Thank you for what you do.
Yeah.
What you do?
She works over there at Peak, Urban Peak.
Okay.
The reason that these people are living here is because they have the services right there. One poor young man.
That's why it's hot over here. I moved out of the shade. I was like, why am I suddenly...
It gets hot pretty quick, doesn't it? Oh.
That's it. It's gone forever. You lost it.
Well, I was going to put it in the trash. I was trying not to put trash in there and throw my cigarette.
What difference
is it making? I know, isn't that funny? I saw him with the... It happens. It happens because you experience it.
Strong. To
once you are housed, you need to be housed in that same space. Right? And until you have safe space to do that, you're not going to be housed. So then you just have to have the education. Until you have safe space, you don't know how to unpack that.
There's no doubt that's
wrong.
Careful.
This is not new. This goes back generations. This is multi-generational. But it's probably even more than multi-generational. It's probably even history.
How many
there's always been people externalized.
All the way back. Hasn't there always been these kinds of issues?
I have a question for you.
I have a question. I know that Europe has these issues.
Yeah.
I don't know about this.
Yeah.
There was Native American groups, which was groups that followed each other.
Well, there are indigenous groups that did population control.
Yeah. Right, definitely. For thousands of years.
And the Shoshone girlfriend at one time was very clear about that.
Well, there's the history pre-colonization would not
the Apache slaughtered
reflect
the Navajos.
That.
Right.
When Apache slaughtered the Navajos pre-colonization.
Our own stories don't say that. The whitewash stories of us say that,
yes,
but
they
our
do.
Own stories of us don't say that.
But I have a question for you. We're talking about history, but we're talking about what's going on right now, and in Denver metro area, how many unhoused individuals are in the Denver metro area right now? And how many people are on the verge of being unhoused themselves in a couple of maybe paychecks?
I'm not sure if anybody knows the exact numbers.
I mean,
the last point in time count is well over a year old.
Right.
And I think the total was like 6,000, but actually on the street
right.
Was closer to like 1,500. But then if you look at HMIS, which is the Homeless Management Information System, which tracks anybody who touches any homeless service provider, they had over 31,000 unique individuals hit that system in 2020.
Yes.
So
in the Denver
it's really hard to know the numbers.
Right. And it is a fact with everything that's going on with the pandemic and everything that's going on right now, not in Pittsburgh, right now in nationwide, people are really close to being homeless themselves.
Well, yeah, with the eviction moratorium right. ending, I think Colorado had 300,000 evictions
yes.
ready to go.
Ready to go. I know. And I was dropping literature.
So on this, yes. consider if you have 1,500 people on the streets in Denver at any given night, and people think that's unsightly, what does 100,000 look like, right?
Right, exactly, yeah. So, I mean, like, and like you said, history has been whitewashed as far as what's been going on here in America. Indigenous people lived here for thousands of years.
Yeah.
And didn't, so it was.
It, yeah, it hasn't ended.
And we've been here for a couple hundred years.
Well, and this is the same story throughout human history. So we know now from looking back that many societal collapses have occurred because those with affluence hoarded natural resources to the point of societal collapse. And so this is what's happening now. These folks on the street are the externalization of that.
Yes,
and
exactly.
So we're just... If you ever wondered what people thought, you know, as civilizations were ending, you're in it right now.
Exactly.
And we could choose a different way, but we choose to keep repeating the same patterns of behavior yes. and calling it not insanity. But we could choose something different. At any day, any time, you could choose a different path.
Yes, exactly. Thank you. I agree. It looks like they're pretty much done here today. There's one tent left, and then... One over there in their own special little fence over there. Were there two tents over here that they fenced off?
Oh, yeah.
Thank you for being here.
Yeah, you too.
Carol, this young man says your bread pudding is beautiful.
Oh, good. I'm glad you'd like it.
Like buying a brewery and everything else? Okay, I'm pretty sure you have to go down California. Yeah, if not, just stay on the phone. If you're stuck at 22nd in California, I'll just watch that.
Okay, so you
want to
go down
to
Don't touch that.
It's like, buddy, I think you need to go to like the old Grove protest up in Canada. The one where they're getting fucking brutalized by Rocky Mountain cops. Literally.
Thank you.
says her husband took off and stupid husband could be upset too. She's upset because her husband can't see anything, my lens is so dirty. Her husband took off and left her with it, packing everything up. I'd be upset too. So anyway, they went in, the neighbors went in to help her community, taking care of each other. So we're gonna get going. Got stuff to do, take care. Another traumatic displacement day in Denver, another Wednesday. It's Wednesday again tomorrow. See you.